Get in, quick! We're running out of time.
Wait! I'm scared.
Don't worry.
But...
A Federation ship will recover our pods in no time. I'll see you at Remote Station 6. Now get going!
Okay, you'll follow, right? Promise?
Promise.
Activation complete. Ejection in 10 seconds. Distress signal operational.
Okay.
Searching for life supporting planets. Planet found.
Where?
Vanguard 3. Located approximately 0.5 light years from present location. Axial tilt of 35 degrees results in extreme seasonal weather. Existence of humanoid life forms confirmed. The Federation has classified Vanguard 3 as an underdeveloped planet. Civilization level, approximately equivalent to 16th century Earth. Would you like to review the Underdeveloped Planet Preservation Pact?
Yes.
The Underdeveloped Planet Preservation Pact was established in order to protect planets with developing civilizations. Contact with civilizations that have not reached a certain level of development is strictly prohibited by Federation law. This is due to the fact that contact with advanced civilizations has a high probability of greatly influencing the course of history on a less developed planet. All individuals and organizations belonging to the Pan-Galactic Federation are required to adhere to the tenets of this pact. Unless faced with a clear danger to life and limb. This pact is one of the most important components of Pan-Galactic Federation law. It also serves as a guideline for civilian conduct in emergency situations. Violators will be tried by the Pan-Galactic Council.
How long till we get there?
At our present speed of warp 6, arrival is estimated in 144 hours.
Are there any foreseeable problems in getting to Vanguard 3? How's our energy reserves?
No foreseeable problems. An adequate supply of energy and food is on board.
Okay, I guess I'll get some sleep. Notify me if anything happens.
Affirmative. Entering Vanguard 3's gravitational field. Prepare for entry turbulence.
here we go. So this is Vanguard 3. Since they haven't contacted me yet, I suppose it'll be a few days before they come rescue me. I better keep an eye out for danger. After all, this is an underdeveloped planet. My quad scanner's picking something up. Moving at 40 clicks. Might be an animal. I hope it's not dangerous. I should use my replicator to make myself a weapon, just in case. A sword would be a good match for this planet's level of development. I don't want to get arrested for violating the UP3. Luckily, I've gotten used to this kind of weapon in the battle simulators. Not that I feel very lucky right now. I sure hope I don't end up having to use this thing. Yeah, that feels about right. The sun will be setting soon. I better find someplace safer to stay by nightfall. If there is any safe place on this planet. There's something there. I'll try expanding the range a bit. It's picking up humanoids. Based on this reading, I guess it's a village. If I start out now, I might be able to make it by nightfall. I'll go. I know it's a UP3 infringement, but this is an emergency. They'll probably cut me some slack if I keep a low profile.
Thank you.
Made it. Finally. That was farther than I thought. Looks so close. On the scanner.
Hey! What's wrong, mister? You got a bellyache?
It was just a dream. Where am I? Wait. I'm on a backwater planet. Did someone rescue me? Who are you?
Are you all right? You were groaning in your sleep.
I think I'm fine, thanks. You the one who rescued me?
No, I just carried you. My sister, Mina, she insisted.
I see. So you were the one who rescued me. Thank you, Mina. I guess I should introduce myself. My name's Fate. Fate Line God. How about you?
I'm Nicholas. Her name is Mina. Fate. You said Fate, right? Your clothes and your ears. Are you one of Norton's men?
Norton? Is that a person's name?
Yes.
I don't really understand the situation here.
I know who he is, then please, never mind. I apologize for the odd question. You still need to recover your strength. Feel free to rest here a while. We cannot do much, but we do have food.
I'm fine. No, really.
No! You should stay in bed!
Please, rest. Don't worry. It is our way to help each other in times of trouble.
Sorry. Thanks.
It is no problem. Mina, let him get his rest.
Okay.
He looks so young. He seems so mature for his age. Just like Sophia. Hurts a little, but I can move. I'd better figure out more about this place. No telling how long I'll be stuck here. Wait, where's my sword? Nicholas must have it. I must have made him nervous. Or I had It's not like I need it right now anyway.
Thank you.
What's that?
It's my treasure box. Daddy gave it to me on my birthday.
That music box was passed down through our mother's family. It is the only thing we have left from our parents. But alas, it is broken now and does not make a sound.
I see. Can I have a look? Gearbox is broken, but I bet I could fix this. If I can get back to my pod, I should be able to synthesize parts. I don't think the UP3 prohibits repairing existing devices. Yeah, this shouldn't be too hard. Want me to fix this for you? It'll be my way of paying you back for rescuing me.
Really? Can you fix it, Tig?
Can you really do that? It is an expensive music box. They told us it would cost a great deal to fix it.
True. With this planet's level of civilization, the parts for this wouldn't come cheap. If I can get my hands on the right parts, yes, and I think I know where to get them. It's a little ways away, but I'll go get them later.
But we cannot ask you to do something like that for us.
You saved my life. It's the least I can do to repay you.
Still.
And I'm sure that Mina wants it fixed, right?
Thank you, good sir.
In return, do you think I could get my sword back? I won't be able to go through the forest without it.
You swear you are not with Norton and his gang?
That I'm not. What? You don't believe me?
No, I trust you.
Thanks.
But be wary. If you are not one of Norton's gang, you will be in even more danger outside the village.
I know. I'll be fine. What happened? The pod's parts and equipment have been stripped. There's no way the inhabitants of this planet know what this stuff is. It'd make sense if they just smashed it up. No use wasting any more time here. I better get back to the village. Hello there.
What a relief! You are well! Norton's gang was lurking around the forest in the direction you left in. We were worried.
Nicholas, could you please tell me more about Norton and his gang? Who are they?
I do not know everything myself. Norton appeared suddenly in our village about half a year past. He ordered the village to supply him with food. Of course, we refused at first. The village needs its supplies to survive the harsh winter. Norton was in fact ordering the village to die. But when people refused him, he called upon this mysterious light, and those it touched disappeared, one after the other. Carl, Siren, Kurt, all gone. And our father, who resisted until the very end. Of course, we told our Lord, but he said the idea of people disappearing into thin air was nonsense and didn't want to hear about it. Now some of the villagers have even joined Norton's gang.
A mysterious light that makes people disappear? Nicholas, when you first met me, you asked me about my clothes and ears, right?
Ah, yes. Norton wore clothes made out of a strange material that was neither linen nor cotton, just like the clothes you wear. And his ears were shaped like yours. That is why I did not trust you at first. I apologize.
Don't worry about it. It's nothing. I was just thinking. But thinking isn't going to help anything. He may be dangerous, but I'd better go meet this Norton guy. I might even find a way off this planet. I'm really sorry, but it's going to take me a little more time to fix your music box. Can you wait just a little longer?
Okay.
That thing Norton's gang carried off, did it belong to you?
No. I thought it might be, but it wasn't. Don't worry. I'll fix your music box.
Nicholas, I'm hungry. Let's eat.
Ah, yes. Very well. Let us eat.
Thank you. Out of my way! Out of my way!
That was easy.
of my way!
Please! If you'll only spare my life!
I think I'm getting the hang of this.
Who are you, kid? What do you want? This is Lord Norton's turf, so beat it or else.
I don't want to fight you guys. I just want to know if you've seen a little boy around here.
A little boy? Oh, you mean Nicholas. Yeah, he came around here blabbering about getting something back and wanting to see Lord Norton.
Then what did he do?
Being the kind-hearted fellas we are, we gave the stupid kid what he wanted. I bet Lord Norton's re-educating the undisciplined little brat right now.
What?
It's the kid's own fault. Nothing good can come from messing with Lord Norton. Don't worry. He'll learn it's better to join us than fight us. It's a shame. The apple don't fall far from the tree. Idiocy must run in the family.
Rotten little...
Whoa there! Didn't I just say you can't pass through here? Wanna see that brat? You gotta beat us first.
What gives you the right?
Looks like we got another village idiot in need of some education.
Ha-ha, a real fight! Out of my way! Hiya! Ta! Ta! Ta!
Yeah!
think I'm getting the hang of this. So Nicholas is locked up somewhere in here. I better hurry up and find him. Real fight!
What do you think you're doing? Oh, please! If you only spare my life!
That was fun! This Norton guy's an off-worlder too. What he's doing here.